Hello, as you can see, this is not a normal video. Today we're just visiting Tarr Steps in Exmoor. Got a friend, my old friend Brian, for at least 25 years, coming down just to say a quick hello. Just thought we'd film the event. Beautiful area. Yeah, and the ongoing situation does have its benefits because there's not many people down here, which is great. Water's crystal clear. If there's any wind noise, I do apologise. I think there's a storm rolling in. But look at the water, totally crystal. Now, I'm not quite sure, so you'd have to excuse me, I'm not actually sure how old this bridge is. I have read it before and I did know, but as I'm getting older, my memory is like a sieve. And that's looking back across. So we're going to just walk up the other side of the river, see if we can see any of the brown trout. So, Brian, you're live on YouTube. Well, not live, but what do you think of the Tarr Steps?
Absolutely wonderful.
Brian likes it. Yeah. I used to stop the tree trunks. Yeah. There's one of them over there, look. Yeah, you can still traverse this in a car. You go through the ford here, look. Just go all the way through there and out. Sarah standing on the stone like a kingfisher. Right, I'll catch you in a while. Okay, still walking along the river. Seen a few brown trout, but as it's not quite so sunny today, it's quite tricky to see. But the water is absolutely crystal clear. Here's another little viewing spot. Oh, that was a gimbal, not me. And onward. There's a pool up here where you can see the fish normally, so we'll go and have a look. Back in a minute. One of the many sort of rock formations on the route. And obviously the river is starting to get below me a bit now. I'm gaining a bit of altitude. So clean the water, it's ridiculous really. So nice to see that even in this modern world there's some nature that hasn't been completely destroyed by the human species. But I would imagine that we've had a good go at destroying it. Ah, there's one of those wire catch nets. I think it's just a catch when the river's in full spate. It will catch any trees so they can be removed when the water's fallen back. Didn't work too well. There's a bloody great big tree trunk just there, look, in the centre of the screen. Right, I shall get back to you. Yeah, just another section of this beautiful river. Mini waterfall and rapids just here, look. Try and get a vantage point without breaking my neck. Sort of place I'd expect to see a white-throated dipper as well as a kingfisher. Not heard the kingfisher yet. Okay, even further along the river. Making our way up to a pool I know of. And it's usually you can see the trout sitting in it just sort of doing their stuff. Look at that. It's really smooth, crystal clear. Girt big tree over there, look. But look at this water. It's absolutely crystal clear, isn't it? Look at that. Crystal clear. See, this bit of the river is running deeper. Look at that. That joins onto that crystal clear piece I've just... But you can see right to the bottom easily, and you can see the rock shelf over the other side, look. Problem being, spotting a brown trout in this, in its environment, camouflages, it's just, you ain't got no chance. There are some flies on the top of the water though. Walking along the path, and another part of the beautiful part of the river, look. just had to pause briefly to let two idiots with their dogs go past. Not on the lead. Of course, little weasel there is on his lead, behaving himself. They're bounding around, no leads, no control. Typical sort of day. People are so ignorant. Beautiful. This river even comes with its own beach now and again. See the current whistling around this stone, look. Just come across what I call the trout pool. We've been there here before. Can't see any trout normally on this side because you need a bit of altitude. And that's up towards the bridge that we'll be crossing very shortly. Oh no, I thought I was going to catch that for prosperity. The dog very rarely gets in water. Right, on towards the bridge. Okay, this is another shot looking back down stream onto the pool. Obviously you can see that it's quite moist. But at the moment we're under a nice oak tree that's shielding us from a lot of it. Just trying to see the residents in the water, but at the moment, because of this rain, we're not doing too good. Okay, this is our sort of jump point where we cross the river and work our way back. Brian's got knackered knees and hips, so he's done, and I've got a knackered knee, and I'm just about done, so. Let's do a runner while we can. As you can see, it's quite moist now. This bit of ledge of rock is bone dry, give or take. I think weasel can smell otter because they're supposed to frequent this area. There's a view back up the river. A little mini sort of island, if you will. this is where this path sort of rejoins the main one. I think we're getting very close to the money trees down here. Yeah, there's one, I think. I think we're gonna, yeah, there's the money trees. I think we're gonna hammer a couple of coins in. Like crocodiles' backs. Look on these trees. Nope. Look, all coins, thousands of them. That's the main trunk. It comes back up this branch. To the end of that tree. And then this big thick trunk. I'll just get the bloody dog from out of underneath my ankles. Here's another 8 million coins. Thousands upon thousands upon thousands upon thousands of coins. So, give you some sort of perspective, look. Thousands of coins. And there's even a pound coin hammered in there, look. Don't know if that's focusing or not. Thousands and thousands of coins. Magic. This is the river right behind the money trees. This moss, it looks like old man's beard. So obviously looking back to the money trees. Okay, it's getting very moist now, so I think I'm gonna have to put the camera away. Hey ho. Right, well, thank you very much for watching, and I hope you join us for the next one. Hoping to get back to some proper exploring within the next week or two. I've had other stuff to do the last few weeks, I think sort of real life has got in the way, sort of thing. But soon we shall be heading south on several explores, so stay tuned. As I always say, stay well and stay safe. Thank you very much for staying subscribed, and I'll catch you again soon. Bye bye.